Hello my dear student, today we will try to solve one more mob problem by Castiglione's method, unit load method and strain energy method. We will try to find out the deflection at the center of the beam for a given load. So this is the problem where we have varying moment of inertia. So 3 meter moment of inertia is 2i. And again here 3 meter and moment of inertia is I. This is, let us take this as D, this as E, 1.5 meter and 1.5 meter. So this is the problem given. Let us try to find the deflection at the center. This is 3 meter. So let us try to find the deflection at the center of the beam. That is, we will try to find out the delta C. So first, let us take this 20 kilonewton as P. So take 20 kilonewton load as P. Now we will find out the reaction RA and RB. To find out RA, let us take sigma MB is equal to 0. So we get an equation, RA into 9 is equal to P into 4.5. RA is equal to P into 4.5 by 9. Therefore, RA is equal to P by 2. RA is equal to P by 2. So, once we calculate RA, we will find out RB. RA plus RB is equal to P. Therefore, RB is equal to P by 2. And that we can say by symmetric also. The beam is asymmetric completely, therefore RA is equal to RB is equal to total load by 2. We have taken 20 kilonewton as P, so P by 2 we get RA is equal to RB is equal to P by 2. Now we will prepare a table here, portion, origin, limits, EI, moment, the partial differentiation of moment with respect to P, and for unit load method let us take mx. So in this problem we can see here we have a portion. Because of symmetric we will try to solve only for the half portion. Multiply by 2 will give the deflection for a complete beam at C. So here for half portion, we'll, because of symmetric of the half portion, we will take only two portion, that is AD and DC. So for AD the origin will be A, and for DC the origin will be D. And for limit of that AD, we'll have the limit of 0 to 3, and for DC it will be 3 to, that is 1.5 means 3 to 4.5. So AD, DC are the portion, A is the origin, D is the origin, 0 to 3 is the limit for AD portion, and 3 to 4.5 will be the limit for the DC portion. So the portion is here AD and here it is DC. Origin will be A and here it is D. Limits will be 0 to 3 and 3 to 4.5. EI, it's given EI and 2 EI. So these are the things which is given. Now we'll try to find out the moment. So to find out the moment, consider a section here xx at a distance of x from A. So you get RA into x. RA we have calculated already, that is P by 2. So here you will get P by 2 into x. In the same way for the portion DC, you get P by 2 into x. Now this moment has to be partially differentiated with respect to P. So first we will take x by 2 as a constant term. So delta P by delta P. We know that delta P, the partial differentiation of P with respect to P will be 1. Therefore this is equal to x by 2. In the same way for this also you will have x by 2. So after this, for a unit load method, what is the thing we have to do is remove all the load acting on the given beam, and apply a unit. Unit means 1 kilonewton at the point where you have to find out the deflection. So because of the symmetry, we can write Ra is equal to Rb is equal to half of the total load, that is 1 by 2. So here again we have DC portion. So take a section xx at a distance of x from A. So for AD portion you get 1 by 2 into x, that is x by 2. In the same way for DC portion, consider the xx portion x. So you get x by 2. So this is the table. Now we will try to solve the deflection at C by all the three method. The first method is Castiglione's method. Castiglione's method. So the Castiglione's method say that the deflection is given by integration 0 to L mx by ei into the partial differentiation of that moment with respect to load into dx. So this is the equation for a Castiglione's method. So now to find out the deflection, we will write 0 to 3 for the portion AC, P by 2x EI into x by 2 dx, and for DC it is from 3 to 4.5 PX by 2 EI into x by 2 dx. So other than the x, because we are integrating with respect to x, other than the x the all other terms will be a constant term. So p 2 into 2 is 4 by ei. The same way here also we have p 2 into 2 4 ei. So we will take those term outside. This deflection is equal to p by 4 ei. So integration 0 to 3 x square dx plus 1 by 2, I will take outside this 1 by 2, and then 3 to 4.5 x square dx. And we know that the integration of x raise to n is x raise to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So we will get here x square means x cube by 3, 0 to 3 the limit, and here also it is x cube by 3, 3 to 4.5. Now I will take 3 term outside, 3 and 3. So it will be p by 12 ei into 3 cube minus 0 plus half of upper limit minus lower limit. So we get p by 12 ei. 3 cube means 27 minus 0 is 27 plus half of 4.5 cube will be 91.125 minus 27. So you get this as P divided by 12 EI. P divided by 12 EI. So this we get as 27 plus 64.125. So after simplification and substitution you get this as 98.438 divided by EI. So this is delta for the half portion. So delta at C for the complete portion will be 98.438 into 2 times divided by EI, where we get this as 196.876 divided by EI. So this is the deflection at C or at the center of the given beam by Castiglione's method. So in the same way we will try to solve this by unit load method. So unit load method. So in unit load method we have a formula deflection 0 to L mx by ei into mx dx. So for this problem we will apply the values here 0 to 3 px by 2 ei into x by 2 dx plus 3 to 4.5 px by 2 ei into x by 2, this is 2 ei dx. So take the common term outside, you get p by 4 ei integration 0 to 3 x square dx plus 1 by 2 integration 3 to 4.5 x square dx. So here you can check we have the same equation here p by 4 ei p by 4 ei integration 0 to 3 x square dx plus half of 3 to 4.5 integration x square dx, the same equation. So once you simplify this you will get 98.438 divided by ei. So multiply that by 2 because of the symmetry, definitely you get delta C is equal to 196.876 by ei. So this is by unit load method. Now we'll try to solve the same problem by strain energy method. So strain energy method, the deflection is given by 0 to L m square by 2 ei dx, which has to be equated with the energy equation, or you can say strain energy is equal to equation half p delta, that is strain energy is equal to integration 0 to L m square by 2 ei dx, which has to be equated as half p delta. So now we'll try to find out first the strain energy u. U is equal to 0 to 3 px by 2 ei, that is m square we have to do, so px by 2 whole square divided by 2 ei dx plus 0 to 3, sorry it is 3 to 4.5 px by 2 whole square 2 ei, we have it in the formula and in problem here for the DC portion we have 2 extra, so that is 2 dx. Now we will write u is equal to, I will take 1 by 2 ei common first, 1 by 2 ei integration 0 to 3 m square is p square x square by 4 dx plus this 1 by 2 I will take outside, integration 3 to 4.5 m square is p square x squared by 4 dx. So we have to integrate with respect to x, so other than the x whatever constant terms we have I will take that outside, p square by 4 is a constant here and also it is constant at this point p square by 4, so I will take this p square by 4 also outside, which will be equal to p square 4 to the is 8 ei. Now integration 0 to 3 x square integration we have plus half of integration of x square dx, so this is the equation we have, right, x square dx. Now what we will do, write p square 8 ei. So integration of x square we know x cube by 3 0 to 3 plus 1 by 2 x cube by 3 3 to 4.5. So here we can write p square by 8 ei here it will be 1 by 3 into 3 cube is 27 minus 0 plus 1 by 6, this will be 4.5 cube, that is 91.125, minus 3 cube will be 27. So this we get as p square by 8 EI into 9 plus 10.6875. 91.125 minus 27 divided by 10 will be 10.6875. So here you get 19.6875 p square divided by 8 EI. This is strain energy U. So this strain energy is equal to work done. So we will take this as 19.6875 p square divided by 8 EI will be equal to half of p delta. So here you get delta is equal to 19.6875 into p divided by 4 EI. So this is for a half portion. So now you can take for the complete portion, that is 2 into 19.6875 and P is 20 divided by 4 EI. Therefore, from this simplification, you get delta C is equal to 196.875 divided by EI. So this is what the answer you get. This is by strain energy method, and here you have by unit load method, and here you have by, this is by Castiglione's method. So this is how you have to solve the deflection at the given point. Thank you.